Hello, BCCO. Microphone? Yes? No?
Hello.
Welcome. Go ahead and find your seats. And once you have found your seat, per the usual, go ahead and stand up out of it. Start by placing your feet shoulder width apart. Find that bounce in your knees, swaying slightly side to side, front to back, finding that nice centered posture where our spine is aligned and we're balanced over kind of a grounded foot placement. Go ahead, place your hands on your hips, rotate to the left and to the right, saying hello to your neighbor. And then hello to your other neighbor. Good. Go ahead back to the center. Lock your hands together in front. Lift those over your head. And then stretch out to the right. Left to your left. One day I'll get it. Keeping, again, that kind of balanced, grounded footing. Keeping that balance in your knees as we stretch out through our right side. And then slowly bringing over to the other side. Yeah, exactly. To the other side, to the right side. Once more to your left side. See, I'm learning. Good, always keeping, again, those nice relaxed knees, thinking about engaging, and then all the way back over to your right side one more time. And then go ahead and bring that back to center. Slowly float those fingertips down without smacking your neighbor who you just so nicely said hello to. Drop your head to the left, slowly roll through to the right, feeling some of that stretch through your shoulders. Back over to the left. We'll do each side one more time. Go ahead, drop your head to the center, and then slowly roll back up. And just do a nice yawn and stretch out your jaw a little bit. Feeling kind of waking up that hinge joint in our jaw. Good. Okay, we're gonna breathe in for four, out for eight on a shh sound. And we'll make sure that shh is nice and focused. It's very, the stream of air is supported and consistent throughout and should be a nice, healthy mezzo forte dynamic. So we'll breathe in, ready, and breathe in, two, three, four, and out. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Once again, breathe in, two, three, four, and out. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Good, really nice dynamic, well supported. We're gonna breathe in for four, out for 12 now. So you wanna adjust the speed of your breath out so that you can still have that consistent support all the way through the exhalation. So here we go. And breathe in, two, three, four and out. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. And again, two, three, four and out. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Good. So now we'll breathe in for 4, out for 16. As we breathe in for this longer exhalation, which in theory would support a longer phrase as we're singing, we want to make sure that we're breathing all the way down into the bottom of our breath. So feeling like you're expanding your diaphragm down, that your ribs are coming out, and you're breathing into your belly, filling your breath kind of from the bottom up, rather than filling the breath up here first. We want to feel like we're filling the breath down in our belly. So here we go. And breathe in, 2, 3, 4, and out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Good, we'll do one more of those. And breathe in, 2, 3, 4, and out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Very nice. We're gonna, 11, oh, I can only count it to 12. You all did it right, and you passed the test that I failed. Good job. okay, so I was thinking about what we're doing next and not counting, but we will next. We're gonna hum a little bit just in our low register. Mouth will be closed, we're humming, but keeping that jaw nice and relaxed, almost moving as if you were like chewing a piece of gum, kind of working out that jaw, but activating the low register. Then we'll move to the middle and then to our high register. So humming just in our low register. Mm. Moving up to the middle register, keeping that jaw moving, keeping it nice and relaxed. Mm. And up to the high register. Good. Okay, let's start in D. So as we hum, now keeping that jaw nice and relaxed, still thinking about bringing the sound forward and making it as active as we can. So feeling like we're focusing that sound through, bringing it almost like a nasal quality, feeling that vibration, really active forward sound. Here we go. We'll go back to D. So same pitch pattern, but now bringing this to an open vowel sound. So we start on A, and as we open to ah, we want to keep that sound forward. So focusing on keeping the ah vowel more forward, tucking your chin, feeling your jaw open kind of like down and back to help bring that sound out of the back of our throat into a more forward, active vowel. Here we go. One more. Good. Okay. Let's go back down to D. Ah, nice comfortable place. Oh. So this exercise, really thinking about supporting the pitch with the breath, we want to think about the arpeggio not as like a parabola shape, but like a St. Louis arch shape. Like we're supporting that pitch, reaching the pitch from above. You can add a little crescendo to it. Keep that vowel again nice and forward. And as we're gonna start on the O vowel, we will open to ah as we go higher. But as we start on O, keeping it as a nice, pure vowel sound as well. Oh, like our nice French O vowel. So here we go. Oh. One more. Good. Let's go to C major. So a couple things to think about. Still nice forward open vowels. As we are having, we're singing with the more staccato sound, supporting with the diaphragm, engaging your core, and supporting that staccato with the breath. As we move through the higher exercise, the higher portion of the exercise, we go up in pitch. Think about keeping the sound nice and relaxed, nice and airy, and just creating that vertical vocal space. So here we go. Have a seat and take out the block. We're going to start on part three. So we are on page 37. And it's been a couple weeks since we did this part three? 2 weeks? Okay, so it's been about 2 weeks since we've done part three, unless you're a soprano alto and you came to sectional yesterday, and we did a lot of part three. But we are gonna start on page 37, two measures before rehearsal 38, and we're gonna read through the a cappella section, and then we'll kind of go back and work, just to refresh our memory, and then we'll go back and work on some things. Let's go back to the beginning. So I think there's a couple things to pay attention to just in general throughout this section. It's very chorale-like, it's very melodic, and it's really important to have an idea of where the phrase is going so that you can plan your breath accordingly. Because what's happening right now is the phrase is kind of dying at places where it should not, because we're kind of running out of breath. It's also important to note that we don't always all breathe together. So the sections, like, for instance, the basses on page 38 on the first system, everyone breathes in the second bar except for you. So it's important that you support that phrase all the way through to your breath, which is different than everyone else's. So let's try that. We'll go right on your entrance at 38. Basses, in your entrance to the second bar of 38, you can be a little bit more present because you do enter at a different time than everyone else. Make sure that you breathe together as a section there. Let's try that again right at 38. So this section where we just stopped, that's like the first kind of long phrase of this section. And we have the same text twice. Yiyu le ratzon imre fi. And each time there's a crescendo, a swell, crescendo de crescendo. I think the second time we can build a little bit more intensity, make that a bigger dynamic swell. As we always say, we shouldn't sing the same text the same way twice. So we want to make that second part of the phrase a little bit more of a statement, and that has a little bit, the feeling of resolution then will be more when we get to the end of the phrase. So let's go once again at 38. Yeah, excellent. Tenors, altos, and sopranos on page 38, the second measure. Can we all cut off the word fi, an eighth note early, so we have time to take a breath all together? Really finish that statement, breathe together before we start the next statement. The phrasing was really beautiful, and I'd like to do it again with that breath in there. Same place, 38. Yeah, good. Let's separate this section out a little bit. Before, I'm on page 38, second system, and I'd like to hear just tenors and basses only from the third bar of the second system. And one. Yeah, so can we make sure that we take a breath together and that we land right on the pitch rather than scooping up to that first pitch? Once again. Yeah, good. And then basses, just watch out for that first measure on page 39 that you change after beat two. So it's one, you change pitch one eighth note before the tenor, so it will sound just a little staggered there. Once again, same place. Yeah, good. Question for you, Ming, actually. The second bar of page 39, should the basses also take a breath there? Yeah. So basses, bar two of page 39, can you add a breath mark before you say le fa ne just to match the tenors? So for tenors and basses at that measure, page 39, bar two, you'll cut that half note, one eighth note short. So add an eighth rest for your breath there. Let's do that one more time from the same place with tenors and basses, adding that breath, and then we'll go back and do sopranos and altos. Let's have now sopranos and altos from your second bar of page 38, second system, second measure. I'd like to do that again. Couple things. It is a little bit flat, so think about bringing that, creating more vertical space for the vowels, so not spreading them sideways, but really opening those vowels vertically, bringing them more forward. And altos especially can make more of the crescendo in your second measure there. You have a really beautiful moving part. So let's try that again from the same place. The pitch was better, much better, more supported. So I think also there is a little bit of breath planning, like I said, involved in this part of the movement here. So really do try to get those first four measures all on one breath, which really means that on the breath before your entrance, we have to breathe all the way, like I said, all the way down into your belly, thinking about a nice, full, deep breath. The other thing that I think is happening that's causing the pitch to go down is that our half steps as we're descending in pitch are just too big. So just really think about small steps as the pitch goes down. Let's try it one more time. Same place. Thank you. good. And then altos, that C sharp, D sharp, E. The D sharp is going to feel really high. Much better. I'd like to add tenors and basses back. Everyone from that same place. So tenors and basses, be ready for your entrances. Yeah, good. So tenors and basses should be aware that as the peaks of your phrase are one measure after the soprano and alto. So we have this kind of cascading dynamic happening. Tenors especially, make sure that as you go, some of these phrases, as you go to the higher portion of the phrase, that you're, again, create, it's falling a little, the pitch is falling flat at the top of the phrase. So just open that vertical space for the vowel and support with the diaphragm on the higher parts of those phrases. Let's try that again without the piano this time. See how our pitch was there. What's that last chord? Yeah, not bad. Pretty good. Let's go back now, put that together with the first phrase from 38, again without the piano. And then we will go on at 39, and in Thai, if you want to join us when we get to 39. 38, a cappella. Adonai is really falling back in the throat. So bring that vowel forward a little bit more and kind of tuck your chin to help bring that sound forward and make that vowel a little bit brighter. Can we try right on beat two of rehearsal 39? There, before the più tranquillo, I'm on page 40, the third measure. I would not diminuendo until your second A natural. So sing all the way through that A, G sharp A, that really beautiful suspension resolution there. On page 39, the last two measures, the second to last measure of page 39, we all have a breath together before the second statement of Adonai. we should add an eighth rest there for that breath. It really should be like a completely clear space for the choral breath, and it will feel probably like a very large space because the orchestra is not playing, but we do really want to hear the space for the second phrase there. So once again, at 39, starting from the second beat. So as we get to the più tranquillo, the dynamic is less, and we're losing pitch because we're not supporting that quieter dynamic with the breath. So even though there's less volume, you still need to support the breath in the same way, even in some ways even a little bit more so, to keep that pitch lifted as we're in this quieter dynamic. So let's try right on that, the amen. So I'm on page 40, the last two measures of the first system. Can we hear that first chord again?
Don't let it fall backwards. Make sure it's not too in your throat. It sounds froggy like that. You want to make sure that it's resonant.
Let's just hold that first chord on the ah vowel. Let's do it again, making sure that we hear the pitch in our head before we sing. So what's happening now is we're scooping to the pitch, and we want to, again, kind of think about landing on that pitch from above, supporting with the breath. Let's try it.
Don't go, make sure that you don't stretch your neck, because what that does is it stretches for the muscles, and then it creates tension. And what you want to do is make sure you tuck it in yourself.
Thank you.
So the thing is that even though the music is beautiful and sweet, I want you to take a breath with Sam the way it's together. So it's not just everybody just sing together, but done. Because that's the only way for it to stay. So when she takes a breath, let's do the very beginning. What's the first?
Thank you.
That's really good. Can you start from Adonai, with bottom 39? Bottom 39. And poco animado. Crescendo from piano to mezzo forte. Okay? Yeah, last two bars of page 39. Again, you hear it.
Second Adonai. Yeah, so we're just going too high for the D natural. The C sharp is a little flat. Yeah, so it should change on the downbeat one before.
Yeah, just because it looks like you get to this point and you're like, ah.
Oh, I see. Yeah, yeah, yeah. They just need a down beat.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Now, as far as the subject of time with the crescendo, and everybody else playing, oh, we need another beat. We need all of them. Can we just do the same place, but no strings? Together, and So none of this is just one note at a time. It's all of it's within the smaller phrase, which is part of the bigger structure. Okay, can we just do it from 38 all together for a second?
Good, okay. So we went on. Have we read this part yet? I don't think we have. So, from 41, we kind of resolve this section. The orchestra plays kind of the reminiscence of the melody that we just sang, And then at 41, we start a new section and the character changes. So it's much more animated, it's more rhythmic. So we need to think about switching the character of the music. Let's try from the choral entrance. I'm at the pickup to the fourth bar of 41. And let's just do it on ta with no text. Here we go. Three, four. Good. Let's try that once again. Think about making this one long two-bar phrase. One two-bar phrase. Here we go. Three. Good. Let's speak the rhythm together. So we have, I'll say it for you first, and then we'll all speak together. We have three. Ta 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 ta. And one thing that will help this stay rhythmic and feel animated is that the half notes are full value in this phrase. So here we go. Speaking the rhythm together. Ready. Ta 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 ta. Good. Let's go back to the pitch now, still on ta. Three. We're going to try it again from the same place. Bearing in mind that now that we have changed the character of the music, the character of the breath also needs to change. So before, we were taking nice kind of like lyrical breaths. We had a little bit more space for the breath. This is going to be a little bit quicker, and it should be more rhythmic breath here. So let's try that again. Three. Yeah, much, much better. Let's add the text back now. Once again, with a text. Ready?
Okay. And so we get, and then not quite sure.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, hit the fourth beat away from you. And.
Try it with me.
How's that musically for them?
It doesn't sustain. When the pitch goes down, the phrase loses energy.
Okay.
Yeah. So when this phrase, the high point of this phrase is the second downbeat. So shechem. And as we go down in pitch in the full bar, the phrase is losing energy. So really crescendo all the way through to the second downbeat, even though the pitch goes down. Let's try it again. Good. And we are losing tempo on the rim, ra, she, hem. Those eighth notes are slowing down a little bit. So think about pushing the rhythm through to that downbeat as well. Let's try again. Ready. Excellent. Let's go on to the next entrance on the next page, page 42. So same thing here. The phrase goes now to olam, to the half note is the kind of high point of the phrase. Make sure as the pitch goes down in the middle of the phrase that we still crescendo through.
Okay.
ready. Oh crap, I'm gonna breathe.
Can you just do that? Just say, right? Right. Repeat, sorry, same thing.
The same place. It's top of page 42.
Yeah, I hear tenors going, hold on. And everyone else is like, going towards the end, right? That's what she just said. Try that again.
Let's put those two phrases together now. So we will go from, 41 so we can hear what happens before we come in. I'd like to do that one more time, mostly for me to give you more preparation for your breath. So, from 41. So be aware that the measure before your second entrance here, so the first measure of page 42, beat 4, there will be a fermata, and I'll cue downbeat and then your entrance.
So you can also have the measure like that. Two things you can do is you can sing that a little bit so you get an idea. Mm-hmm. But also, let's do 41.
go on.
We'll go on to 42. 42. Right on the measure. So tenors and basses, be ready for your entrance. Beat three. Yeah, so it's quite a bit faster here. So what happens from where we just stopped, we have four measures to reach this new tempo of animato. So it's quite a bit faster in three, right at 42. Here we go. Good, and it should sound like one long thing that goes all the way to the fermata where we just stopped. There is no, it just kind of, it's like a snowball rolling downhill, right? It just gets bigger as each section enters and it picks up energy as we go through. Let's try it again, same place. Making sure that we are breathing in time before our entrances. Here we go. Two. Good. Be aware that I know it's a little bit confusing sometimes because the English rhythms are sometimes superimposed underneath, but rhythmically, the whole chorus lines up. At the top of page 43, the last two measures, or two beats of the last bar, that 4-4 bar at the end of the first system on page 43, the last two beats, or the last beat, really, is all together, the eighth note there. So just look for that as a place to line up. Let's try again. Now, the kind of phrasing is there, and the phrasing and the energy are good, but we are lacking consonants and articulation. So this section needs to have a little bit more consonants at the beginning of the words, and it can be a little bit more separated and kind of grounded. Molto ritmico. Here we go. 42 again. Good, and lots, especially cavo, that K should be a big consonant there. One more time.
Cavo. So you're really good with identifying concepts. I think
I don't
give them
isolate it a little bit more.
Yeah. So maybe like tenors and basses, since they do it at the same time together, and then since they don't do it at the same time together.
Yeah. Okay. Let's try just tenors and basses from 42. Looking, you have the cavod twice, so make sure that K comes out the third measure of page 43 and also right before the consonant as well. So 42, tenors and basses. One, two. Good. They're kind of missing the breath in between the phrases here.
But did they do the K's?
The K's were better.
The K's are better, but they could be better.
Better-er. Place the K before the beat, and I think add a little bit of, like, a little air in the consonant.
Why don't you do that bar on page 43, half system, third bar. So what Sam mentioned to me, she gives me is that I'm not taking a good enough breath.
Pitches. I just, yes, the pitches. Here we go. One, two. Yeah.
So you have two goals, and then the breath has to happen, right?
Think about the breath as being really quick, and don't forget the end consonant of vod. It will help you place the breath. Here we go. One, two. Yeah, that was excellent. Excellent. Can we do that now? So good. Can we do it now within the phrase? So starting from 42. Good. The second part of the phrase after the breath is lacking a little bit of energy. So remember that this is like, even though we take a breath and we have a second part of the phrase, we're really going all the way to the fermata. So after the breath, maintain the energy of the phrase. One more time, tenors, basses. One, two. Excellent. I think more K on your second kavod. The first one was excellent, and the second one could use a little more K. But we will go. I was going to do altos and sopranos and put it together, I think. Altos and sopranos. Now, from the top of page 43, here we go. We are getting a little bit tripped up on the eighth notes at the end of the first system. Melech HaKavod. Just move through that rhythm a little bit more to the downbeat. Melech HaKavod. Let's try that again. And one. Much better. Can our opening me have a little bit more open to the vowel of me with a little bit more impetus, me, so the M doesn't get quite so. The M is a longer consonant, but it still needs to be rhythmic in this case, so that will help us. Try again from alto soprano entrance. And one. Excellent. Tenors and basses, join us, please, at 42. Nice catch. One, two. Excellent D at the end of kavod as well. Shall we? Let's continue on to the next page. That was really excellent. So I'm now at top of page 44, rehearsal 43. And we have changed character once again. We're back to a more lyrical character here. So, here we go. Yeah, let's try again. The breath can be a full beat breath before this entrance. The sound is just not quite supported well enough. Try again. Yeah, we'll start from one bar before. So you'll hear Ty play the bar before your entrance, and then we'll come in on 43. Good. Can we try this without the sopranos momentarily? So, same thing, one before 43. If you move on beat four of the second bar of 42, so that would be altos, tenors, altos, alto ones and tenors, bring that out a little bit. One before 43 without the sopranos. Just the altos. So alto ones are quite flat. It's a little bit higher in your range, so you have to think about bringing that pitch, supporting more with the breath, bringing the vowels more forward will help, and thinking more bright vowel sounds will help the intonation stay up. Just altos alone, right on 43. Yeah, good. So when it goes down to that F sharp, that's where we really lose the pitch. So make sure that F sharp is nice and bright. It is, yeah, the F sharp should be just a little bit higher. Once again, altos. Yeah, good. And then G, G, A, C. The G to the A also is going to feel like a very large whole step, so just bring that up a little bit. Can we add tenors and basses to that at 43? Yeah, good. Altos, I think, even more lifted in that third bar there. I'd like to try it once with everyone before we take a break. Or do you want to work on it?
Do that, and then I'm going
to do something. Okay, good. Let's add sopranos to that, please, at 43. Right on 43.
Look at the dynamics of the game. And so you have threes and a lot, right? But join. So we're just asking for maybe a show of hands of those who might be interested in singing, so we can get back to her. I don't even know if we're singing in German or English yet, but.
It's a great band.
Okay, super, that's great.
have time.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go to the Duraflé, the eighth movement, Liberame. Page 66 if you have the piano vocal score, but eighth movement. That's our band. Okay, and just here we are. Basses? Tenors. Altos. And sopranos. Good. Not bad. Not bad. Let's do basses.
Libera me, Domine, de morte.
Can you make sure there's no breath at any of the lines? You can take a breath where you need to because it's a long line, but we want to make it seem like it is one unbroken line, okay? Basses from the beginning. Remember, piano is not piano. This should be warm and rich and full. And not loud, but I mean like warm and rich and full. Ready? And so much better. Now we see a little bit more vertical. Libera, and I want you to think more horizontal. Libera me, Domine, de morte eterna. Okay, right, right beginning. And yeah, I still hear you pull away from the long notes. Libera me, do, instead of using it as an opportunity to grow. Libera me, Domine, de morte eterna. You have to use, remember how we said before in previous weeks, sometimes when you want to make things sustained and legato and sostenuto, you have to think about actively having a mini crescendo to connect the notes, right? And oh my goodness, that was absolutely gorgeous. That was exactly it. That was absolutely gorgeous. Now, the one thing I want to make sure that we always do is that we don't the quick notes are within a rhythm, because we get a little snappy with it. Libera, libera, libera me, Domine. So it's not libera me, Domine, right? You want to make you sing through the 16th note, okay? Sing through the 16th note, but that was fantastic about the sostenuto. It's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Ready? And that's it. Yeah, almost. Yeah, yeah, that was so great. The first one is libera, libera me, Domine. See if you can make the second one just Domine, right? But again, it's more about the sustaining of the first note. Libera. If you go libera, then it feels like you kick it. So really sustain through crescendo every line, ready, every note. And libera. Good. Hey. That's exactly it. And Sally. Yeah. So the same thing for here. We're going to have no breaks. Hindi, what's it, E? In 81. In die la tremenda, quando sali movendi su, sunt etera. See if we can do in die 81. In die. So the same thing as always we say. There are so many syllables that they put a flag for every single one, but you should really feel like it's one huge long legato, right? In die, instead of in die, right? And two, one, two. Not bad, this. That's it. Yeah. Terra. Yeah, see if you can just make a rolled R there, but that's good. Let's do tenors. Now, tenors, the same thing for you. The pickup to 82. Tum veneris judica. Really sustain. Tenors alone. Two and. Yeah. Let's just do Judicare. Do vanity, Judica, right? Let me just hear Judica. What I hear is Judicare, Judicare, secla. The same thing, the same exact thing. That's the basis. Crescendo every long note, so it really sustains through. Okay, just do. Judicare, right there. One, two. Yeah, that's much better. Now, judicare, no glissando. Judicare seculum. Okay, let's do dum veneris, right? Beginning. Two and. Yuri, just go kare and da. Yeah, so no kare. Kare, right? And just that, and kare, and da. Now, I still hear a gliss. Somebody's going, kare, ka. Just sing that. Kare. No, but not a. So you can make it not too low, right? Ka. Okay, right, and just to connect it together now, and yeah, that's it, okay? Make sure you don't gliss down. Now, can we have basses alone pick up to 82 second bar? Dum veneris judica, right? One, two, three. Yeah. Can you play the chords underneath too? Listen to this. Ty's going to play your melody plus the chords underneath. Ready? Two. Yeah, it's kind of weird, right? Let's hear basses alone. Two, three. Do. F. Yeah. Yeah. So the same thing. Make sure there's no glide. Eureka. What's an F? Re. Ka. Re. Ka. Re. Not ka. Re. Right? Ka. Re. If you can't do it, do it a D. Can we do tenors and basses from the beginning? Very beginning? Very beginning. Liber me domine, right? Two bars before, and breathe together. And altos. Good. Let me hear the altos. Pick up to 83. One, two, three. Yeah, I think this is going to be the exercise for everybody to get off the get American R's out. I hear Yudikare everywhere. Yudikare, Yudikare, Yudikare. It sounds like there's a guy named Ray from Utica. Let's try altos. Where do you sing that? From the beginning. Dum veneris judicare se. Right? One, two, three. Nice! Yeah. Seculum. That one is a straight eighth note, so make sure that it feels very secure. Let's do sopranos. Now, this isn't... You start from a lower register, and then you have to think about head voice. So don't do a belting Broadway thing where you kind of stay in the same register. Switch the first note from chest voice, and then go to head voice immediately. What's it again? Doom, fatalis, instead of doom, fatalis, right? Doom, switch, fatalis. Right, one, two, three. Yeah, so the hard part is that you're in the middle of it getting faster and faster. For now, let's just do it one tempo, so we kind of get locked in, and then we'll change the tempo as we go on. But for now, let's do it one, two, three, doom, veneris, judica, right? One, two, three. Yeah, E flat. Yeah, just so E niem and da. That's it? Yeah. And then I wouldn't do too much E, but I, like it's an I vowel. Like it's a little taller. Right? Let's just hear that. I, and da. Yeah. And the same thing. So make it I and then er. So I, just go I, right? To just no consonants. And da. Yeah, and then we get the chord, right? Now, very, very tiny. Get the tiniest touch of the consonant in between, right? And da. All right. Why did that one suddenly become weird? That was just a vowel, right? Right? And da. Yeah, that's much better. That's much better. So the key is when you get higher, you actually have to open up a little bit more because you have to create space for the notes. And so you can't sing an E, right? You have to sing an E, E. And you need to open it a little bit more. So instead of para enium, it's para E for you, for the sopranos. Okay? Let's do everybody two bars before 84. Two bars before 84. Yurika re. Yeah, right? Yurikare, right? Two, one, two. Almost. Let's do basses alone. Right? And da. Yeah, and then with the tenors, we have a nice little clash here. Listen to it for a second. So there's two clashes, right? Right, one, here we go, one, tenors and basses, one, two. Yeah, now, what's the C? Yudikare, sustain the last note so we can hear the note, right? One more time, tenors and basses, dumba, one, two. Yeah, that's it, okay? Let's do it with the altos and sopranos. One, two. Yeah, without the basses, right? One, two. Yeah, so that's a major C major chord. See if we can get it. And just sustain it just for the end so we kind of feel it together, right? One, same people, no basses. One, two. Good. Now, basses, you have a hard part because you're not really in the chord most of the time. And so it's always one note off. It's like a seventh chord, right? And you're always the seventh note. So let's do that with basses this time. Ba, 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 la, 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 la. Right, one, two. Yeah, right? Now, yurikare, let's do that fast. One, two. That's good. Let's do from alto entrance. No, actually, let's do tenor entrance 82 with basses. And if you can help out the basses, they kind of have a hard part. So 82. Yep.
Tum veneris judicare.
Right. One, two. Sorry. One, two, three. One, two, three. Basses. Altos, and. Good, let's hear those last chords, just E, Nyem, or I. Ah, major chord. A, N. That's really, really nice, right? That's really nice. Really, when you sing louder, you need to sing deeper. You need to feel like you're like a tree with lots of roots for your foundation, and then your canopy is really lifted and high, okay? Let's do that one more time. I want you to focus on the pickup notes. Dum veneris. So we get dum veneris. We have the pickup note to be a little bit more present. I feel people are kind of latching on at the very end, and it gets a little bit like lost, right? Tenors, tenore, two, and basses, and nice. One, and two, and three, two, excellent, and two, excellent. Tenors, basses, and tenors, sopranos, and nice. Yeah, your chord is fantastic. Can we hear the E flat major chord? Let's just play. Just you play it. Ready? Right? And then, can you play it with your bass note? Like, we have a beautiful E flat major chord, and yet the chord is this. Right? That extra note just gives it a little bit of darkness. That's really fantastic. Okay? Let's do Quando se li movendi sunt eterna. Page, oh sorry, rehearsal 87. Jeez. Listexica I am. Quando sili moventi sunt eter. All right, one, so play with us. Ready? One and two. Yeah. Eterra, right? Eterra. This is our exercise. All right, let's do that. One more time. One, two. Much better. Much better. It's starting to fade away when we remember to do that. Now, can you add terra, a little bit of a rolled R because we have two R's there? So just do the last bar only, terra. So bar before 88, lucky number. Yeah. This is like a mystery chord. Who did it? Right? Terra and da. Better. Can we make it a little bit more, it's a little in your face, terra, like you're going to sing terror, but this is terra. Make it a little bit more mysterious. And, yeah, better. Some of you are rolling your R's, some of you are flipping your R's, but many of you are still doing the glide with your lips. And that's why it sounds like an American R. Terra, terra. Terra. See if you can do it without moving your lips. Terra. Terra. Right? Let's just do those last two. And. Almost. Almost. Sopranos alone. Ready? And. Yeah, I still hear. Terra. It's like you're singing, you're a fancy wine person. You're talking about the terroir. Terra, right, and sopranos. Almost, it's the glide too. I hear terra, like it's some terra, right, and da. Almost, that's a little better. That's a little better. Can you connect the two? Like I hear terra, terra. But without the glide. Ready? And that's it. That's much better. That's much better, right? Let's do everybody from Quando sili movendi sunt. Sunt. Quando sili. Right? One, two. Oh, that's much better. That's much better. I would say 20% is still there, but it's better than 90%. Terra. Now, the sopranos on the third bar of 87, it's okay to put the T where nobody else is putting the T, on the third beat, right? Cuando solemo vendes un etero. Don't worry about that. Nobody else is going to do it, but that's fine because that's what he wrote. Okay? One more time, 87. Or as the French would say, 427. 1, 2. Dies illa, dies irae, calamitatis et miseriae. Remember this part? Maybe not that fast. Ta, all right, let's do 88. And 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And and 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 2, 3. Yeah, not bad. Let's do 90, 4, 20, 10. So sopranos and tenors, unison. Basses and altos, unison. So it's actually just two parts. So let's hear the C, and then the E. D, a, C, la, right? 1, 2, 3. Yeah, good. D, S, E, la. So unlike what we were talking about before, make sure every single note has its own due. 1, 2. Yeah, good. Now, what I hear is this. Dies, dies, la. It's a dies, la. So every single note it sort of almost feels like it's the same length. Don't make the last one suddenly longer. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Dies, yeah, that's it. Now, let's do the next one, which is just one extra rhythm, right? Let's put both of them together because it's easier, right? 1, 2, 3. Dies, 1, 2, 3. Good. So this one, you have you go 1, 2, D, S, E, la, 1, 2, D, S, E, right? So you have to go take a quicker breath for the second one. One more time from the first one, which is rehearsal 90, 90. And 1, 2, 3. One quick breath. Good. I think you need to take a quicker breath. Let's do the second one. I'm going to do this. 1, 2. D, S, E, D. Okay, the second one. Ready? One. Here we go. 1, 2. Almost. Anticipate your breath a little bit more. Ready? 1, 2. Good. Excellent. Now, can you do the same thing with a D? 1, 2. D, S, E. Right? 1, 2. It's just so quick. It's hard. It's like, oh, surprise. Right? 1, 2. Yeah, that's great. That's great. Let's put them together. And 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. Go on, 2, 3. Good. So, calamitatis et miseriae. So you want to ta da da ba ba. You want to feel that third beat very strongly. So look, if you look up again, 1, 2, calamitatis et miseriae. Let's do that, everybody together. Calamitatis et miseriae. Right, and from the beginning of the bar is 1, 2, 3. Yeah, sorry. I'm not cueing your next note. I'm cueing the beat that you bounce off the next note. Calamitatis et miseriae. Right? So don't move on the next note. It's not calamitatis et miseriae. Right? That's it. And 1, 2, 3. Yeah. One more time. All right, sorry, let's do it. I'll conduct it. One, two. Let's do it a cappella for a second, right? One, two. Yeah, that's good. The same thing. Calamitatis et miseriae. Calamitatis et miseriae. Right? Let's do that together, okay? With the piano, right? Three bars before 90. One. Three bars before 91. Numbers. And one. End. Yeah. And the last thing is that that last note is long. Calamitatis et miseriae. Off, right? Last time. One, two. And yeah, not bad. Suddenly you're like, oh, these are different notes. So there are three notes now. Basses, you're on your own. Let's hear 91. 91. No, just sorry. Basses alone, 91. Right? Basses alone, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, not bad. Was it Exxon Valdez? Valdez, Exxon, right. Let's do 91, basses low, one more time. 1, 2, 3. Good, let's add the tenors, right? 1, 2, 3. Sorry. Add the tenors, so basses plus tenors, right? 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I hear the notes, and you just have to remember aha maha laha, aha maha raha va de, right? Let's add the altos. Right? 1, 2, 3. Yeah, not bad. Right now, because we're still reading it, it feels a little bit like a fun ride. We're like, oh. but not bad. Let's add the sopranos. Right? 1, 2, 3. Good. Everybody say aha maha raha, right? And ah. Yeah. So wait, what? Aha maha raha. Aha maha raha. Now, the goal is to not feel like you slur them. Aha maha, but aha maha raha, okay? For clarity of notes, right? So you're going to go dies ma nya e aha maha raha va de. Okay? Let's try that. 91. 420, 11. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I can. You know, like maybe 50% of us were successful at it, and it cleared up things so much, really, really nicely. Can we just do aha maha raha valde? So this is before 92, three bars, second beat. So again, before 92, three bars, second beat, just for the aha maha raha valde. Right? I'm going to give you one aha ma. Right? Two and one. Yeah, a cappella, two and one. That's excellent, except for the American R. Aha, maha, raha, vale. But that's much better. The clarity of the notes is phenomenal. Let's do 91. And then this time, Ty is going to play only the orchestra part, which does not have most of your notes, and see if we can do this, right? 91, two, and one, two, three. Thank you. Yeah, not bad. Not bad at all. Can we do from 90? 90? Maybe this is the last thing we do. 90, right? Yeah, okay. And two, and. Two, three. Two, three. Not bad. Yeah, good. So next week, let's read one more thing. 95. Rehearsal 95, which on some people's books is measure page 75. Exactly what we did before with the basses and everybody else, sustain through the long notes, right? Right? And leave. No breath. And. And. Tenors. Beautiful, beautiful. Tenors and altos. Beautiful. So we're going to start looking, like I said last week, at all the block third, fourth, and fifth parts, working through them, because we need to do that now. And then, of course, all the movements of the Dirflay that we haven't done that we need to look at. Okay? Great. See you next week. Thank you, Ty. Thank you, Sam. Woo-hoo.